How do you do? I'm Dr. John Sace. Welcome to Urban Economics Advanced Topic Number 6. In this video, we will explore the effect of production output on monocentric bid rent. Production is related to employment, and employment is related to income. This, in turn, is related to bid rents for the local real estate. As discussed in Advanced Topics 2, agglomeration economies tend to lead to higher rent values and higher levels of employment density at employment centers in which the agglomeration occurs. This creates local bid rent peaks known as business subcenters. Therefore, proximity to an employment center can lead to conditions that produce a concentration of productive capital within a specific business or industry that lead to the development of agglomeration economies. Higher levels of employment density come with agglomeration economies as related businesses are drawn to the subcenter. In turn, the bidding for best location leads to higher rent values. Let's take an example of a concentration of auto dealerships that compete with one another near a major intersection in a city or suburb. Each dealership sells a quantity of cars for which the price remains relatively constant for similar models and various brands. In order to analyze this situation, we use a supply-side model of production. In this model, we assume that the value added in the form of output is a function of three determinant variables. These variables include large E, the level of employment in the subcenter, large L, the quantity of land used to produce the sale of automobiles, and mu, the distance of this subcenter location from the central business district, the CBD. In short, quantity of production sold equals a function of employment, land, and radial distance. More succinctly, we can express the relationship among quantity, employment, land, and distance in the form of a Cobb-Douglas function. In this function, the quantity, large Q, is a function of radial distance and equals the scalar, large A, which varies with radial distance times employment, large E, taken to the power of alpha times land, large L, taken to the power of 1 minus alpha. This implies that the sum of the exponents must equal 1. As further conditions in this model, the first derivative of the scalar, capital A, is negative in respect to radial distance mu. This suggests that the right-hand side of the equation decreases as radial distance from the central business district increases, assuming ceteris paribus. In addition, the first derivative of large Q in respect to radial distance mu is negative, which implies that sales by auto dealerships decrease as they locate further outward from the city center, with the exception that sales may increase if a subcenter develops away from the CBD. As dealerships are competitive with one another, we will assume a competitive economic profit of zero at price P star. As total revenue equals total cost, we can express this break-even condition as P star times the quantity, large Q, sold. That decreases with radial distance mu being equal to the wage level, small w, times the localized employment plus cost of land used. In other words, rent. By holding total revenue equal to total cost, we can derive the BidRent function in respect to mu, the radial distance. As a production function represents the quantity sold by the dealerships, we take the first derivative of this function and multiply it by the price P star. Next, we take the first derivative of the cost of land function, small v, in respect to the radial distance mu, and multiply this by large L, the quantity of land demanded. Thirdly, we set these terms equal to one another such that P star times the derivative of the production function equals the land demanded times the cost of the land function. If we divide both sides of this equality by large L, the demand for land, the firms will change their offer price for land as they move further away from the city center. In this respect, the offer price will decrease as the radial distance from the CBD increases. To conclude our analysis in our auto dealership example, we find that sales decrease as the radial distance increases. We know this because both P star and capital L are positive. Therefore, the first derivative of the production, the sales function, must be negative. Also, it is for the same reason that bid rent declines at increasing radial distances. I hope this has helped you to understand this somewhat terse subject. If it has, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment for topics that you would care to view. Thanks and have a great day.